Hi, and welcome to another installment of Daz3d, How to Make It Free. In these How to Make It Free videos, I really just show you how to modify the ever-loving crap out of something solely so that you can, so you don't have to pay for it. That's really it. That's my mission statement. In this case, I'm actually making an avatar of a recognizable movie character. This is the actor Peter Cushing. He was General Tuck in Star Wars. I need this character for sort of a parody I'm working on. But I don't have his hairstyle. It looks like he's got a little bit of brown, a little bit of white, and balding with kind of a heavy widow's peak. The closest thing I have is this guy. The height is right. The receding hairline works. It's not quite as far as I'd like, but it's there. But here's the big problem. Sideburns and shaboom. Yep, none of that quite matches that. And the color is wrong. So I'm actually going to fix the color first. Go to surfaces, see base color, base parent. Most Daz3d figures have some options for it. His hair's not quite white. That actually is pretty darn close. So I'm actually going to go with that. Now, I'm not going to change the sideburns because I'm actually going to make his sideburns go away. Go to Tools, Geometry Editor, right-click, make sure this is selected, then right-click. Select kind of mod. You want Marquee. If you don't have Marquee, you will be selecting individual segments of polygons, and this will take forever, so make sure you're right here on Marquee. Get it kind of a good 90-degree angle. Click, drag, bring it down, and it will only attach itself to the selected item. And I recommend you hold it for about 3 seconds should be good. Here's why. Because I've also selected the opposite side polygons on his face. Right click, geometry visibility, hide selected polygons. Might be a little bit more obvious what I'm doing. Come back here. Hold, hold, hold. Visibility, hide selected polygons. And I know I'm making him bald back here and I don't want to. But there is a solution to that too. Now, when I want to blend this, I actually spend less time. Remember how I recommend you hold so that all the polygons are selected? In this case, you kind of want that to not happen because it kind of gives you this nice, more natural look. And I don't think his hair comes this far forward. That's closer to where I want it. And I actually do need shots that actually show the back of his head. So the easiest way to deal with that is to come back up here, turn my cursor back on. Not have anything selected. Go to hair. And let's see. This wild man hair actually kind of fits, make sure not to load it to the character right away. Now instead of hiding this one part, it's functionally the same process. I'd selected polygons. Now for this wild man hair, I'm gonna try to match it in surfaces. Now, once I have, let's see. Once I have all the polygons hidden that I want, I'm going to take, just get rid of that right there. It's probably okay. Now just go up here to diffuse color, browse, and I'm going to take the surfaces from the same texture that the other hair came with. Then up here, fit it to Genesis. Doesn't quite match. Looks like it was an issue with the ambient strength in this case. And it looks like that is how you do this. If you have any other questions, feel free to comment. If you want to help me out, please subscribe.